Helldivers 2 is a challenging and really ludicrous co-op game. It has some surprising depth, and this video is here to cover some things you might have missed and arm you with a few creative tricks. Let's get to it.
You have maintained our way of life.
You can delimb both bugs and automatons. Automatons will chase after you after being literally disarmed, unable to do much more than a one-handed punch, and bugs will drag themselves along at a much slower pace. This is essential when tackling faster or larger bug enemies in particular. You can not only kill friends and smaller enemies with your drop pod, but full-on bosses like a bile titan, as well as destroy buildings. Automaton dropships can be shut down before they offload troops, saving you a lot of time running away from dual chainsaw-wielding maniacs. Weapon mechanics are more complex than you might think in this co-op shooter. Planets can have different environments and they affect weapons in different ways. Cold planets will slow down the rate of fire of some standard guns, and at the same time can benefit laser weapons by keeping them from overheating as quickly, which makes sense. Mines bury themselves deeper in snow, making them harder to see, so watch out, pack accordingly. Many weapons have alternate fire modes, including how fast they fire. It's not immediately obvious how to do this. Hold down the reload button and you'll get a menu of options such as turning on and off attachments, going to single or burst fire, and other modifications. In the menu, set your weapons to remember they were last aimed down sight or third person with remember aim mode. This can save a lot of time when pulling out SMGs for close range versus sniper rifles for long range. Specific limb damage can happen, which affects your ability to aim and shoot certain weapons, as well as how fast you can run. It's just something you should be aware of if your aim goes all wobbly all of a sudden, or you'll find yourself hobbling around. Limb damage is highlighted above the endurance bar at the bottom of the screen. Calling in stratagems involves a D-pad minigame that takes time you may or may not have at the moment. Fortunately, if you're fast, you can drop a shield generator relay which forms a bubble temporarily, blocking incoming damage. Use this time to call in bigger orbital bombardments, which can now be dangerously close. You know you are a compulsive reloader. You've gone to Compulsive Reloaders Anonymous many times and it never worked. It's time to make a change, citizen, because in this game, every magazine you throw to the ground half empty is just ammo on the ground. It's never too late to change. I believe in you. If you simply can't stop yourself, take a tube-fed shotgun. They are incapable of ammo dumping. Apes stronger together. Some of the heavy weapons in the game drop onto the battlefield in two parts, the weapon and an ammo backpack. You or a teammate can pick these up and or drop them separately. Although you can fire weapons like the GR8 recoilless rifle by yourself, there is a very slow reload process during which bugs will be looking to snack on your face. If a teammate is there with you, they can pick up the ammo backpack and reload your weapon quickly. The supply pack in particular gets overlooked and not only lets you walk up to teammates and hand them ammo to keep them topped off, but when you walk up to supply drops, it lets you store up to 4 supply crates and bring them with you. In general, some enemy types are very bullet resistant. You're more likely to encounter these enemy types when fighting automatons, but some big bugs have the same type of resistance to regular weapons. If you shoot them, even with a stratagem dropped M43 machine gun, your bullets ricochet and may even be a danger to your fellow citizen soldiers. To punch through, carry heavier weapons such as the autocannon. As a matter of fact, probably don't wander into the automaton area without weapons that at least mildly penetrate armor. Stratagems are physical marker grenades that get thrown out to request things from the ship in orbit. You can actually look up and see the ship drop items or fire from orbit. It's a really cool detail. This also means the stratagem calling grenades rebound off of enemies and redirect the strikes back at you or with larger enemies, and you should do this, get stuck on them, meaning orbital strikes will adjust and land directly on them as they move around. The dive in Helldivers takes some getting used to. Most video games let you roll away from danger, but not this game. You dive to prone, which completely kills momentum, a huge hazard when getting swarmed by bugs. Use dive mostly to get away from airstrikes quickly, get behind cover quickly, or to get low and lay down some heavy machine gun fire more accurately. Be careful jumping through crevices, the environments are procedurally generated and might not make enough room for you to get through, leading to you getting stuck and heavily murdered. There can be random modifiers applied to each round, and pre-planning what to take with you will make things go much smoother. You can see what modifiers you are facing in the effects menu at the bottom right. Examples are extreme cold, which reduces the rate of fire of some weapons, and orbital fluctuations, which increases stratagem cooldowns by 50%. Some missions start you with less ammo during rationing, so when facing the above, take laser weapons, which will be able to fire for longer, and more supply stratagems, which are weapons you can use until they run out of ammo, as opposed to airstrikes with already longer cooldowns. On top of different enemy types, different styles of missions will benefit you from carrying more airstrikes or more turrets, depending on if the objective is to destroy or defend, and how much time you have. You also see things like reduced visibility from rainstorms and smoke. Some of these effects, like bug-induced fog clouds, can be cleared up by destroying the right structure. If you feel like you're progressing through unlocks too slowly, consider that when you first play Helldivers 2, you'll be playing on the easiest setting, Trivial, which is actually one step below the easy setting. Once you complete a mission on Trivial, you jump to easy, then to medium, and so on and so forth. There are 9 difficulty levels in total, but the higher you go, the more rewards that are on the table. When navigating the galactic war map, beneath each difficulty, it even describes what the levels alter in terms of gameplay. Keep advancing in difficulty levels until you hit a wall. You'll know when you hit one. Take a step back, grind out some of the easier difficulty missions, acclimating you more to the game, and return to some of the harder missions when you are a bit more seasoned. When you jump into a mission in Helldivers, there's a lot more to do than just the primary objective. There are sub-objectives to complete, enemy nests to wipe out, discoverable points of interest, and more. When you jump, you want to get as much done as possible in the time that is allotted in order to maximize your rewards. What helps out greatly with this is a strategic drop point. Don't simply pick the main objective as the location to drop into. Look at the map and drop into whichever objective or sub-objective is furthest away from the evac point, which is displayed as an arrow pointing upward. From there, make a mental note of the path you want to take in the mission to knock out as many tasks as possible, and always leave the closest objective to the evac point for last. It's highly likely that when you get to that final event, you'll be glad you're a hop, skip, and a jump away from evac, with the clock running down and your reinforcements dwindling. Believe it or not, the Starship Troopers-like theme carries through the entire game, and it's pretty funny. Even how casually your deaths are handled are part of the bit. You can find communications devices around the map that tell stories, such as the eulogy template for a soldier who died from friendly fire. There are great details in orbit, you can look out and see ships getting shot down, and realize the war isn't going as well as you're being made to believe. That's what we wish we knew before playing Helldivers 2. Leave us your best, most clever tips in the comments below. For more coverage of Helldivers 2 and games like it, stay right here on GameSpot.